I want to talk with you about proper pacing for longer races like the half marathon or marathon. Because if you get your pacing right, you give yourself the best chance of running your absolute fastest time. So let's take a look at pacing for these longer races. First, you'll have your goal race split, and you can easily get that with the McMillan Running Calculator. So just head to the calculator, insert your time. So for example, I'll put a marathon goal of 3 hours and 42 minutes. Hit calculate my paces. Then obviously the race times tab, this is the one you'll land on, will produce your goal times on the right hand side. And you'll see here's the marathon, 3 hours and 42 minutes. My pace per mile, 8 minutes and 28 seconds. I can also change that to kilometers, minutes per kilometer with that toggle. Now, 3 hours and 42 minutes for the marathon, 5 minutes and 15 seconds per kilometer. And then if you can also get your splits for every segment of the race by going to the race split sheet tab. Here you'll see every mile what your cumulative split should be across the entire race. And again, you can have them in miles or change them to kilometers, minutes per kilometer, and it'll give you the split for each of your Ks along the race. So I think it's important that you know what your average split should be for your upcoming race. Now let's go and look at the different types of splits that you hear athletes talking about. There's really three types of splits in races. The first is even splits. This is where you run the same pace for the entire race. The second is what's called a positive split. This is where you run faster in the first half of the race than you do in the second half. So first half fast, second half slow. The third type is called a negative split. This is where you run slower in the first half and faster in the second half. So slow first half, faster in the second half. And all of these splits have their place in proper pacing for races. So if we look across different race distances, we see that there's different types of strategies that actually yield the fastest racing. So when we look at short races, those races under 10 minutes, we see that even or even slightly positive, so running faster in the beginning than you do at the end, results in the best races. In fact, if you look at the world records for the 800 meters, for example, they will often run faster in the first 400 than they do in the second 400 in those world record races. If we move to medium length races, sort of 10 minutes to around an hour, we see even or now slightly negative splits. So even running the same pace the entire race, or slightly negative, meaning you're running slightly slower in the first half, faster in the second half, yields the best performance. So you can think this is sort of our 5K to 10K for most of us falls into that range. But when we get to longer races, races over an hour, we see that even or slightly negative splits, so medium length, even or very slightly negative, so just a little bit negative, but longer races we see even or slightly negative splits. So what does this mean for you in the half marathon? So for the half marathon, what I've found is here's the pacing strategy that yields the fastest times for athletes. An even split to 1.5% negative split yields your fastest race. So if your goal time, so this would be goal time for the half marathon, let's choose 1 hour and 45 minutes. So an even split would be 52 minutes and 30 seconds. A negative split of 1.5% would be 53 minutes and 17 seconds. So as long as you were in this range, you weren't faster than goal pace, so you weren't faster than 52:30 at halfway, or you weren't slower than 53:17, then you set yourself up for the best half marathon performance. And I think that makes sense, right? Even pacing is smart, but negative pacing typically yields a little bit faster race. So we want to be even to negative, right in that zone. Again, about 1.5%. And you can do the math. You can go and look at what are the splits for your particular exact goal time. But I wanted to give you this example, kind of lay the foundation that you can do some of your own math to figure out exactly where you want to be at each split. Now, when we look at the marathon, I find that even to 2.5% negative split yields the fastest racing. So again, going back to the half marathon, even to 1.5% slower in the first half. In the marathon, even to 2.5% slower in the first half will yield your fastest race. And here's what that looks like for common finish times in the marathon. So again, if we look at 3:30 here, kind of a mid-range on this chart, we'll see an hour 45, that's the half marathon split that would be even, up to an hour 47:37 for a 2.5% negative. So you can see there's a lot of buffer there, but we're not going faster in the first half. We can go up to 2.5% slower in the second half. That will yield your fastest marathon time. Now, why is this important? Why is it important to know the best pacing strategy based on the length of race that you're doing? The first is that early in races, you're not as efficient and you don't have as much economy as you will later in races. Once you get warmed up, once all the systems are sort of engaged at a high level, that's when you're most efficient and economical. If you start races too fast, you're actually not as good at race pace early in the race. So therefore, you're burning more fuel. You're not as economical. So all this fuel and energy you're gonna need later in the race, you're using more of it even at your pace if you're going faster than goal pace. The third thing here is that you wanna keep your brain happy. We know a lot of neuroscience is now showing us that as long as the brain senses that everything's okay, it will allow you to keep pushing. But if you start burning a lot of fuel early, the brain starts getting concerned. And if it gets concerned, then it will begin to shut the power. It'll begin to send more feelings of fatigue. So if you start easy, you've got more fuel, you ease into the race, then the brain stays happy for longer. I also like it because mentally, with this idea of a negative split, we're talking even to slightly negative for the half marathon and marathon, it puts your focus on finishing fast versus hanging on. And if you've been to half marathons and marathons like I have, you can see the people in the second half of the race that are just hanging on. They've gone too fast in the beginning and they're just trying to hold on to their pace to the finish line. Whereas others, you can tell they started appropriately, even to slightly negative, and now they are charging to the finish line. They really have a lot of mental energy and physical energy to get to that finish line. And that puts you in being the passer instead of the passee. And any of us who have done these races, we know it is so much better when you're the one passing people as opposed to getting passed. So that's a real important point in why running your pacing your race is so important. Now, the last component to this is that your personality is unique. So I've worked with some athletes, even some world championship Olympic type athletes that are really different in their personalities. So some athletes, they need to hit even splits. That's where they need to be mentally as much as anything. For them to be 1.5 or 2.5% slower, like I mentioned for the half marathon and the marathon, they're not comfortable with that mentally. It concerns them too much. So for that athlete, they need to be more on the even split side. Some other athletes are more comfortable warming up in races. They like finishing fast. They like to know that they're conserving, kind of holding. They really want to be the person that isn't just sort of running even, but they want to be passing a lot of people, running fast at the end. That person can move toward the slower end, the more negative end. So the 1.5 to 2.5%. So you need to think about for yourself what might be important, what might suit your mentality, and we want to take advantage of that in your pacing strategy. So I hope this little video helps you kind of understand the different types of pacing in racing. You've probably done that before. You've had some even split races. You've probably had some positive split races. You probably had some negative split races. And I wanted to kind of inform you from my experience and what we know by looking at successful races from athletes is that for these longer races, like the half marathon and marathon, would really like you to be even to slightly negative or a little bit more negative for the marathon. So again, even to 1.5% negative split for the half marathon, even to 2.5% negative split for the marathon. If you do that, you set yourself up for really having a great race day. And that proper pacing, if you've got it dialed in, you've got a great strategy going into the race, it can help you be really calm as you're running the race. You see a split that's a few seconds slower than goal pace early in the race, you know you're fine. You're right in the correct zone because you're going to negative split that race. So think about that as you get ready for your race. As always, let me know if you have any questions, and I'll talk to you again real soon. Take care.